and we're not always going to get it right. We just have to make sure that we teach our children how to honor us. And how we do that is we show, when we teach them, if we're teaching them to respect us, then we need to respect them. Ask somebody to tell me, respect children. Yeah, if you teaching them to respect elders, then you teach that elder to respect your children. All children need to be respected too. Somebody told me, well, I don't believe that. I said, well, I tell you what, the next time you talk crazy to my child and you disrespect them and he disrespect you, I'm going to get you. Period. Because if I'm teaching him to respect you and you don't go for him, you come to me. You come, you bring it here. Don't do that. Because I'm teaching him right and you're teaching him wrong, and then I got to go back and then I got to beat him from disrespecting you. So then he get a whooping for what you done. So there's ways that you can teach your children. Because listen, I told my kids, I will support you 100%. If you are right, I got you. But if you are wrong, I am not accepting the wrong that you're doing. You're going to get chastised. You're going to be punished. And if I have to beat you, I'm going to beat you. My kids ran away. He's run away a couple of times. Yeah. He ran away and stayed with the word. Go figure. Who does that? You run away and you still go to work. I'm not going to find you. I don't understand. But it's about training. And I can honestly say that I was not in this place. When we got married, I had three children and he had one. We had Shakira together. But I felt like those were my children and I will handle mine. You handle yours and I got mine. But that's not the way to be. And as I got older in God, I realized it was still sowing discord and division amongst the children and the parent. Because if he would say no, all the children would say, you ain't got to do all that. No, go on over there. It's fine. I got this. I was out of order. I was wrong. But see, and I reaped that as they got older. Because they began to rebel. Amen? So if we're teaching them how they should go, then make sure we lead by an example and we be the example. Because why? We want them to be great. So when they have children of their own, they'll know what they need and they'll get what they're supposed to have. Amen? So now I'm going to flip it a little bit. Because I heard this, and I promise y'all, God brought this in my spirit this morning. Because when I worked on this, I didn't have an ending. But he gave it to me this morning as I was in the bathroom getting myself ready. Luke 14, 23 through 26 says, Jesus said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. So that's the key. The Holy Spirit will lead you and guide you. And if you forget something, it will bring back to your remembrance. But it comes from studying, right? So you have to be able to get, you have to be able to read your word. And if you're not sure, then go to somebody and ask them what you need so you can give it properly. That's right. Amen? So there's a scripture in Matthew 10 and 37. I heard this song yesterday, and I thought about that thing because I really wanted to study it and see if that was the word, because I never heard it. But I heard somebody say they wanted me to hate my parents because my parents were not good people. Okay? So I began to research. And Matthew 10 and 37 says this. This is what it says. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall love it. I'm sorry, shall lose it. And he that loses his life for my sake shall find it. Okay? Now, Luke 14 and 26, and it is the same words by Jesus. Luke 14 and 26 says this. If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sister, yeah, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. This is what this means. What he is saying is, you cannot love those people more than you love God. Because he said over in Exodus 20 and 12, he said, honor your father and your mother, for thy days may be long upon the land, and you'll be blessed. So Jesus don't tell us to hate our mother, to hate our father, to hate our sisters, our brothers, or anybody. He said, do not love them more than you love me. It does not matter what our parents have done to us in the past. God still holds us accountable to honor them and reverence them, need to respect them. Because why? Because somebody like me that has not been taught how to be a mother, that's going to get it wrong and not perfect, and nobody has taught them or shown them how to be a parent, how to do it right, how to even make it right. I myself even had to apologize to my own children when I disrespect them. Because they're not my children. They belong to God. They are still brothers and sisters in Christ. So people say, well, I ain't got to apologize to my child. I'm the parent. That devil is a lie. Because if you want, the scripture says, Father, put both not your children. That is scripture. We cannot put both our children and then expect them to do something that we know that they should not or should be doing. When we cause them to come out of character, we cause them to be disobedient. We cause them not to obey us. We as parents cause them to be on that wrong path. But the older women, we are to teach what is good. That scripture in Titus 2. And for some of y'all who don't know what Titus 2 is, it's called the Titus 2 woman. The older is to teach the younger. The older needs to be reverent in behavior, meaning show lots of respect in your behavior, suitable to holiness, temple-like. Certainly this demeanor would be inclusive of dress, suggesting a godly modesty. Here's what I hate, and I'm going to say I hate to see. I hate to see a woman who was half-dressed and naked in front of her children. I hate it. Because you're teaching your daughters that it's okay to dress the same way. And then when a man approaches them, then you get mad. When they go to the man, you get mad. But what are you teaching them? What are you showing them? So he says, dress modestly, dress modestly. Amen? Amen. 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 Now, I'm not saying that we all do it, but it's me, it's done. Amen. I've seen it on Facebook.
Yep.
And they think it's cute. Ashley bought a shirt, and the shirt was all the way down, and Bishop said, that shirt is about to disappear. She's two. You don't dress your two-year-old like a grown woman. You just don't. Amen? Amen. The word calls for us to have inner beauty, but with an outward action as emanating from inner character. Meaning it isn't what goes in that defiles, it's what's brought out. Reverent in behavior means humbleness. Older women were not to be slanders. Slander means a false spoken statement that is made to cause people to have a bad opinion of someone. Prone to accuse other falsely, gossiping, of course. The devil is the great accuser and user and uses every opportunity that will set us up for failure. It says not addicted to much wine and encouraging the younger woman. So we as the Titus 2 women, we ought to teach the young women how to love their husbands, how to love their children, how to teach them how to be self-controlled, pure homemakers, which means workers at home, kind and submissive to their own husbands, so that God's message will not be slandered. Amen. So we can't teach you if you don't come home to eat. What do I mean by that? This is what we're supposed to do. Teach the word of God. How do you teach the word of God? To those that will listen to the wise instructions of the word, or given a testament of what possibly could happen without us even knowing unintentionally. Because some things we just don't know. But he said, we come into the knowledge of the truth, we ought to walk therein. Amen? So we have to understand that we're not perfect, but we ought to go and be great. To be great as mothers, to be great as spiritual mothers, to be great as godly mothers, to be great as godmothers. Because somebody's going to come to you and they're going to want, you got to have a spirit, a nurturing spirit. Somebody tell me how to have a nurturing spirit. And when I thought about that, then I thought, well, you might be right, because I'm a little hard. Because I just give it. But I had to learn how to realize that you can't deliver something to everybody at the same time, because everybody's not the same. Some people are more sensitive to others. So you got to learn how to come. I told somebody, when you come to somebody, come correct. Pray about it first. Because everybody doesn't receive the same way. I may be able to talk to Mr. Brittany a certain way, but I couldn't talk to Sister Todd that way. I'm going to go with her with a soft voice and talking low. And I'm going to be like, look, dude, you tripping. I need you to get yourself together. Pull yourself. You doing the most. Come on, let's bring it back. Do y'all understand? Do y'all understand that? It's your deliverance. And in your deliverance, the response will be different. Amen. So when I read that scripture about Zebedee's, children in Matthew 20 and 20, we want to say they go break, because we have to be able to be used to minister to everybody. Not just to our own children, but to everybody's children, but with respect. I wouldn't want to go to me. But I will not go to a mother who has a child and have them by the arm and bring them. No, I will not. Like, listen, I have your child sitting over here doing this, da 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 da, and we do it that way. Okay? That's just what I do. Now, a long time ago, I did do that. I'm like, dude, I'm about to drop kick your kid. I fight kids, like literally. I will beat your child. My sister-in-law got mad because she asked that her boys could spend the night. Sure, they could spend the night. And they were just doing the most. They were jumping on beds. I was like, look, So I spanked them. Because I told my children, you don't jump on the bed, you don't jump on the furniture, you don't run around acting crazy. So she calls me. And she said, you whoop them? I said, yeah. I just said, well, I don't want anybody with my children. I said, well, then they will never spend the night at my house again. Because I cannot just bring your child down to get around me. I'm just saying, why would I allow your child to come in and disrupt my home? Because I'm teaching them what they need. I'm giving them what they need. But if I can't give yours, then you keep them at home. And we keep it moving. Now, my sister-in-law, God bless her, so she passed on, but she understood. She understood where I was coming from, and I understood where she was coming from, because you do have some parents who don't want you to discipline their children. There's nothing wrong with that. Yeah. I'm just telling you how I am. If I watch your child, they're like, we don't do that. Not over here. No. And I'm just saying, anybody don't agree, that's fine. But again, I just read in Proverbs 23. I just said it. Beat them and they shall not die. Give them what they need. They will cry, they will be hurt, they will go through, but it will be okay. I wanted to encourage you mothers on today. And like I said, this is a message that God has given me, and I wanted to share it with you, because when God gave a message, he gave it to you first. You first. So I wanted to let you know that being on this Mother's Day, it is an honor and a privilege for God to wake us up on this day just to see another day. We've all gone through as mothers. We've lost some mothers, we've gained some mothers, we have godmothers, we have spiritual mothers. I want to make sure that you are able to understand that you may not always get it right, but just don't stay there where you are. Get up, dust yourself up, and keep it moving. Don't be afraid to go to somebody and ask them, I'm having a struggle in this area. I'm having a problem with this. Or what do you think about this? Have you ever been this? Have you ever done that? Listen, somebody told me, you have a story for everything. Listen, I've been through a lot, and I do. I have a testimony for everything. Marriage, finances, children, alcohol, cigarettes, sin on top of sin, I have a testimony because God has been good to me. I thought I was been in this place, and I have not always been. I have not always been a good mother. I lost when Ashley was 5, 6. I lost her for a whole year. Something that I did because I was drinking one night, got drunk. And I thought I gave her a bath, but I didn't. So I sent her to school, and she didn't even get off the bus. I'm like, okay, where's Ashley? Well, I get a phone call from the hospital. DCS then came in because she's got bruises from the top of her back to the bottom of her leg. I was like, okay, well, it wasn't for me. So, well, we don't know that. So we have your daughter, and some people out there see you, and I just flip out. And the thing about it was that she was, my aunt had referred this babysitter, because like I said, I wasn't from Knoxville. I had just come to Knoxville, and I ain't been here a good 2 years, and had to go through this. So they charged me with neglect, and I had to deal with that for a whole year. And the thing about it was, now, I should have learned from that, but I didn't stop drinking, I just slowed down. You see what I'm saying? So, and I just slowed down. Instead of me going out, I just stayed home. So, you know, we know how to, you know, change doesn't happen overnight. Change doesn't happen overnight. So I want y'all to be encouraged and to know that if there's something that somebody has for someone else and you want them to be great, help them get there. Show them how to get there. Show them what they need. And don't be afraid to say, this is what I know, because people tell you all the time, I'm not shaming none of my testimonies. None of them. None. I'm very transparent. You can ask this. You ask me no questions, I tell you no lie. That's just my motto. My motto. If I had no shame in the world, I'm not going to have no shame in God. Because everything that I went through was God. For such a time as this, because I will cross somebody down the road that's going to need something from me, and it'll be sent by God. And you never know, you'll be sitting on the bus going somewhere, or sitting in a doctor's office or something, and someone will just reach out and start talking to you about something, and you'll be able to encourage them and let them know. Listen, my children have been through some stuff. They've been kidnapped. There's been a lot. Over just some simple things of just the know-how and what you need to give. Amen. So I just want to encourage you on today. If you need to be stronger in your walk as a mother, the altar is open. If you need God to show you and to teach you and to continue to give you the strength to even move forward in raising your children or your grandchildren. I'm raising my grandchild. I'm raising my godson. And for 4 years ago, I raised 3 of my grandbabies. You see what I'm saying? So, but here's the thing. You got to have a heart. You got to have a heart so God can strengthen you in those areas so that he can show you what you need and show you how to push you in that place. We're not perfect, but he said, be ye perfect, for thy Father in heaven is perfect. So you can be perfect. If it's just one day, if you can live a perfect day, then let you know that you can be great. God can perfect you in any area of your life. Any area of your life. It took me a while to get here. It did not happen overnight. My kids, they love me. They do. But they fell off when they turned 18 and got older. But I had to give them back to God. And I had to trust in what God gave me, I give it back to God. And say, God, it's on you, God. I can't. So God will give you what you need in the midst of a struggle. He will give you what you need in the midst of a storm. He will give you what you need in the midst of your circumstances. Y'all heard that the old nursery rhyme, old Mother Hubbard had no food in her cupboard. I've been there. I'll make a meal happen. Amen. I'll make a meal happen. One time they can say, okay, noodles again? Yes. And that's what I do. I buy oodles and noodles, so when the food run out, we'll eat all those noodles until food stamps come. Y'all know? Y'all know. If you had that. children. So a mother is worthy to be called mama. We're mamas. Amen. We're a mother because we're a female, but we're mamas to our children. Amen. So the altar is open. If you desire prayer for strength or whatever you need from the Lord, if your mother is living and you want to just pray and ask God to strengthen her in her walk, if she's not here, if you lost a mom and you just need prayer to strengthen your walk and continue to get you to get to where you need it in your walk, the peace in your mind. And I got tongue tied. That devil's a lie. Amen. So if you just want to come to the altar and stand in the gap for somebody else, standing in the gap for somebody else, interceding for somebody else. If you want to, as mothers, if you want to come to intercede for your children and pray that God will bless them and help them when they become mothers. Amen? Amen. The altar.